And then, see, that's what science is so important for, so you can understand what's real.
Hey, aren't you that guy on YouTube?
Hey, cool, you got a YouTube, oh, you got a camera there. Let me tell you about something on my YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
About 3 years ago, I did a debate at Portland State University with Eric Hovind. And Eric Hovind made a statement that was so ridiculous, I didn't know what to say about it. And so I didn't say anything. But in the audience was a sixth grader named Chad, and he basically took Hovind's argument apart. And I thought, geez, I just learned something about how to do debates. You know, it's just ask simple questions. And if you want to see how the sixth grader took him down, just click right here and you can see it. It's only for a couple minutes long. And now I want to introduce you to that sixth grader. He's actually now going into eighth grade, but we'll let him say a little bit about what happened.
In the first video, I asked Eric Hovind how he knew he was communicating with God and how he knows that it's not just his imagination. And in the second video, right here, he still never answered my question.
Okay, I mentioned that in this debate, Eric Hovind said something really silly. It was so silly, I didn't even know how to respond to it. And a sixth grader took him out, Chad. Well, what was that silly thing he said? He says, if you don't know everything, then you don't know something unless you don't know anybody who does. And so I was like, what? Well, maybe a better way to say that is, if you know something that nobody else knows, then how do you know it unless you know somebody who doesn't know it? So that's a little bit better, but I think maybe he should try this one. If you know something that nobody else knows, then nobody else knows it unless they tell you they do know it. And I think that one's the best one, but maybe this one's even better. If you do know something, but you don't know it, then that means the person that doesn't know it really does know it, unless you know somebody who does know it. And so ultimately, you know, they're all kind of ridiculous. But those are just paraphrases of what he said. Actually, what he said was, if you don't know anything, then you don't know everything unless you know somebody who does. And of course, he knows God, and God talks to him. I guess, you know, he's got voices in his head, like Chad was talking about. So, I'll make another video where I talk about some of the tactics I thought Eric Hovind was going to make, but he didn't, and some of the tactics that he did take. And by the way, on that debate, I only had one day notice prior to the event. I was begging him to debate him because I knew he was coming to Portland and he was trying to find a professor at Portland State University and nobody was available or interested. And I knew he was gonna say, hey, I came to Portland and everybody was afraid to debate me. So I said, look, I'm not afraid to debate you, please, let's debate. And he didn't answer until just the day before I got a confirmation. So I really only had one day to prepare. So anyway, that made it fun anyway, the whole thing. It's like, what was this crazy statement? Well, it was like, if you don't know anything, then you don't know something unless you know somebody who doesn't know anything.
Tanya, zoom in.
In the first video, how do you know that? Dang it. I'm thinking. Yeah, I forgot again. In the first video, I asked Eric Hovind, how do you know that those prayers,
About 3 years ago, I did.
Whoops, I accidentally zoomed in.
And in the first video, how do you know? Dang it! I said in the first video, I asked Eric Hovind if. Dang it! In the first video, he never answered my question. How do you know? How do you know it's not your imagination? Dang it! I did this.
So zoom all the way out. Okay.
Yep.
So what are you gonna do?
Okay. In the first video, I asked Eric Hovind.
It just like right when you're in the
Okay.
In the first video, I asked Eric Hovind that how do you know that you're actually communicating with God?
Dang, I did it right. I just forget a little bit.
In the first video, I asked Eric Hovind how he knew he was communicating.